Hello. In this video, we will be discussing specific heat capacity and, more importantly, the specific heat capacity of water. Water. This is because water is a special liquid and it has some exceptions to what we generally learn about specific heat capacity. So when we are taught about specific heat capacity in physics in high school, we are taught that generally solids have a higher specific heat capacity. I've written it as SHC over here. And the reason being is because solids are generally denser. So for a constant volume, let's say that each of these squares here that are in this diagram, let's say each of these squares represent a volume of 1 cm³. Okay, so each of these spaces represent 1 cm³. The reason why solids have a higher specific heat capacity is because they are denser, in short. So if you were to describe it in one word, it would be because they are denser. So in 1 cm³, in a constant amount of volume, solids occupy more space. They have more atoms within this constant volume, as you can see here. There are much more solid particles here than compared to the liquid. There's a bit of space. And gases are really, really spaced apart. They have high kinetic energies, so they move around and vibrate and not vibrate, they move around and collide vigorously. So because solids are denser and there's more particles within a constant volume of solid, it takes more heat to raise the temperature of all these particles. Because now in a denser medium, we have to heat up more particles than if we had to heat up in a less dense medium. So let me repeat that. Since a solid is denser, since there's more particles per unit volume, since it's denser, more heat is required to heat up all the atoms or particles here compared to all the atoms and particles here. Because in this space, in this solid, there's way more particles than in the gas. All right. However, this is not the case for all liquids. Because as you can see here, if you do a quick Google search, you would find that water in its solid form or ice has a lower specific heat capacity than water in liquid form. And this is interesting, especially since we've just discussed and we've been taught in high school that generally solids have a higher specific heat capacity. So have a think, why could this be the case? Why does a solid have a lower specific heat capacity than a liquid in this case for water? Perhaps one of the most well-known liquids on the planet. So this is in joules per gram. In joules per kilogram, this would be 2090 joules per kilogram per degree Celsius. And this would be 4184 joules per kg per degree Celsius. This is because if 1 gram takes that amount of heat, 1 kilogram would take 1,000 times more. All right. So why would water in a solid form have a lower specific heat capacity than water in a liquid form? I mean, we are all taught in schools that solids, such as ice, we draw these box diagrams in chemistry to represent the distribution of particles. We are all taught in school that ice is denser than water. So ice and water, but this does not apply for water. And this is false because actually ice is less dense than water. And if you think about it, this makes sense because this is why ice cubes in your soda drink, or let's say a glacier in the Arctic or Antarctic, that's why those ice cubes float. That's why the glaciers float, because ice is less dense than water. All right. And this is basically the reason why ice has a lower specific heat capacity. And we will look at that in a second. But I would like you to try and wrap your head around this, that ice is less dense than water, despite being a solid. And there are a few reasons for that, and we will get to that in a second. So to discuss this, to prove that ice is less dense than water, and to prove that actually in ice, there are less particles per unit volume compared to, you know, liquid water, we will be using the concept of density. As you can see this formula over here, rho equals m over v. So density is equal to mass over volume. So density is the amount of volume occupied by a certain mass of object. So let's have a look. We've established that ice is less dense than water. As you can see, ice has a density of 0.9187, but liquid water has a slightly higher density over here. So let's calculate the mass of ice in 1 cm cube, for 1 cm cube of ice. So to prove this, we are comparing 1 cm cube of solid ice versus 1 cm cube of liquid water. So we're keeping the volume constant for our comparison here. Okay, so 1 cm cube of ice. We know that to find mass is density times volume. So the density is 0.9187. The volume is 1 cm cubed. And that would give you 0.9187 grams. All right. Now, for water, same thing. Mass is density times volume. 0.9999 times the volume. Volume is constant times 1. So we get a mass 0.9999 grams. So as you can see, if we had 1 cm cube of ice, 1 cm cube, I mean 1 cm cube of solid ice, let's say an ice cube over here, versus 1 cm cube of liquid water, let's say in a small measuring, in a small water dropper, the water would weigh slightly more than the ice because it's less dense, okay? So for the same volume, 1 cm cube of solid water weighs less than 1 cm cube of liquid water. Okay. Let us continue by proving that there's actually less atoms per unit volume. Let's go one step further and apply a bit of chemistry over here. So we're trying to find the moles of ice particles. Basically trying to find the number of H2O particles, H2O molecules here. All right. So if you study chemistry, you would know that to find moles, you would divide the mass of the substance, in this case, the mass of the ice, which is 0.9187. We would divide that by the relative molecular mass of ice, the relative molecular mass of H2O. And that is 16 for oxygen, plus 2 hydrogen. So you refer to the periodic table, you get that for your relative molecular mass. So it would be 0.9187 over 18. And that would give you, that gives you a value of 0.051, okay? So 0.051 moles. And if you want to go another step further and find the actual number of particles, you multiply that, 0.051, times the Avogadro constant, because we know that a mole is basically a big bag of molecules, a big bag of particles, and one mole actually has 6.02 times 10^23 particles. So a mole is just a big bag of particles. So if you want to find the actual number of particles here, actual number of molecules, it's 0.051 times 6.02 times 10^23. Let me just punch that into my calculator really quick. And you will get this massive number. So in 1 cm cube of ice, you would have 3.073 times 10^22, and this is the number of H2O molecules in ice. Okay, now let's do the same for water, liquid H2O, all right? So the mass of H2O we found in 1 cm cube is 0.9999 divided by the relative molecular mass of H2O, which is again 16 plus 2, 18. And when I put this in my calculator, I get a value of 0.05555 moles. You can already see. Okay, let me just round that off to 3 decimal places. So 0.055 moles. As we can already see, there is a larger amount of moles of H2O molecules here compared to here. But just to be sure, let's just multiply this by the Avogadro constant. Okay. And if we do this, we find that the number of H2O molecules in 1 cm cube of liquid water is actually 3.344 times 10^22. All right. Now, when you compare this number up here versus this number, it doesn't seem like a large difference, especially because these numbers seem pretty close to each other in standard form. But let's just take a second to minus these two numbers. So 3.344 times 10^22 minus 3.073 times 10^22. Let's minus these and we can factor the 10^22 out. And so we minus these two numbers, 3.344 minus 3.073. We get 0.271 times 10^22. So, and if you convert this to standard form, it's 2.71 times 10^21. So the difference between the number of molecules in ice, 1 cm cube of ice, versus 1 cm cube of liquid water is this much. That's 2.71 times 10^21. That's 2.71 times 10^21 more H2O molecules in liquid water than in ice. And just to give you a perspective on how big this number is, let's actually expand it. Let's actually expand this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Oh, my screen is shrinking. 18, 19, 20, 21. And let's add all these zeros here. 0000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 So there are these many more hydrogen molecules in liquid water than in solid water, than in ice. That's a huge amount. This is a crazy amount when you think about it. So it's pretty clear that liquid water is actually much denser. I mean, if you were to talk about the number of molecules here, you would say that it's way, I mean, not way more dense. It's more dense than ice. And this is actually something you learn in higher level chemistry, that in the three states of matter, for water, solid water, liquid water, and gaseous water, otherwise known as water vapor, you learn that in solid water, in ice, the molecules are actually further apart, as you can see here. This thing that we are taught where all solids are generally closely packed together is not true. There are some exceptions, such as water, the water we drink every day. And these guys in solid water, in ice, are actually arranged in what's called a lattice of hydrogen bonds. Okay, so they're spaced out and they're orderly arranged, as you can see over here. They have these hydrogen bonds between the molecules. This causes them to space out evenly, and this makes ice rigid and strong and a solid compared to liquid water, where there is less hydrogen bond interaction. There's less of a lattice, an organized lattice being formed over here. So they are much closer together. In gas, however, the logic remains unchanged. Gases are highly spaced apart, so they have a lower specific heat capacity. That is basically it. So because water is actually denser, because liquid water is actually has more molecules per unit volume than solid water, it requires more heat to raise the temperature of all of these molecules compared to all of these molecules in a solid. And that is why liquid water actually has a higher specific heat capacity than solid water. So,